ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
సో హలో స్టూడెంట్స్, లెట్ అస్ కంటిన్యూ విత్ ద స్టొమాటల్ పార్ట్. లాస్ట్ క్లాస్ వి స్టడీడ్ అబౌట్ ద స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆఫ్ స్టొమాటో. విత్ దట్ అనాటమీ పార్ట్ వి ఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్. ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ బేసిక్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ అనాటమీ ఇస్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ to understand the present ongoing topic called transport implants. Now let's come from there. So here we are going to discuss about opening and closing of stomata, or we call this, what are we going to discuss, the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. So there is many theories has been given by many scientists to understand how the opening will be there, how the closing of the stomata will be there. So based on that, we have different terminologies. What are the different terminologies we say, different theories we have. So we discussed for the last class, that's called K plus pump theory, or itself is called as H plus active transport mechanism. H plus active transport mechanism, or this is also referred as theory of K plus transport. All these mechanisms, they mainly speak about what? Opening and closing of stomata. Especially which stomata we are speaking about? Photoactive stomata. Which is the stomata we are speaking about? Photoactive stomata. What is the meaning of photoactive stomata? Photo means sunlight. During daytime the stomata get opens, but get closed during night time. Such type of stomata is called as photoactive stomata, right? So in this, let us discuss the complete mechanism. As we have discussed for the last class, is given by Levitt and established by Rajke and Bowling. So we discuss this point, introduction we just have completed, Rajke and Bowling. Now let us discuss the complete mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. For this, what you can do is take the vertical book, make it into two pages. Take the vertical book and make it into two pages. One second, I'll just show you. One second, guys. So some book I got it here. Just for your understanding, I'm just showing. What you can do is, oh, there is no plain paper here. Anyway, look at here. If you take this book, write down it one side. Opening of stomata, one by one, you have to go vertically down. Other side you have to write closing of stomata. So arrow mark, step by step you have to go down. Here what we have to write, opening of stomata, go vertically down. Here what we have to write, closing of stomata, go vertically down. So take two vertical pages. Let's study about opening and closing of stomata. So here I just take the two vertical pages. So in that, what we have to write, nothing but opening of stomata. And what is the other thing we have to discuss here? The second one is nothing but closing of stomata. Now vertically, step by step, take the arrow marks. Let us discuss the complete process. Go down and write in the vertical page very clearly, because the complete mechanism is very very important. Especially senior by PC, I am telling you, you need to refer first year basics. Anatomy, if you refer the first year chapter, then only you can understand the second year complete chapter. Otherwise it's difficult, because the questions will come interrelated. First year anatomy chapter interrelated questions will appear in the second year concept called transport implants. Everywhere we have right to give the question which is interrelated with the basics of anatomy. So guys, make sure that you revise anatomy first year chapter. Right. Now, let's continue with the concept here. What is the first one? Opening of stomata. What is the first category in this we are discussing? The type of stomata is photoactive. So, when do the stomata get opens here? Stomata get opens during daytime. So, let us see what are the processes which takes place during daytime. Now, during daytime, if you look at, sunlight is available and for this carbon dioxide is available and water is also available. So, these things are available for the plant during daytime. So, there is a opening of the stomata occurs during daytime. It's called photoactive stomata. Right. So, here opening of the stomata occurs during daytime, sunlight, carbon dioxide and water are available. Now, see the mechanism carefully. Whatever I write, just go vertically down. Now, here I am drawing the stomata. Due to availability of the sunlight here, the first step what occurs here is nothing but in the daytime, when carbon dioxide is available, water is available, the plant will undergo the process called as photosynthesis. With the help of photosynthesis, it prepares its own food materials. Okay, what is photosynthesis here? With the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide and water, plant can make its own food by the process called photosynthesis. So, when photosynthesis is there here, what is the food material prepared in this case is nothing but starch. Food is stored in the form of starch. So, the first step is nothing but hydrolysis of starch. What is the very first step which occurs? It's nothing but what? Hydrolysis of starch. So, food is stored in the form of a starch. So, there is a hydrolysis of starch. So, when starch combines with the water, it causes the breakdown of the starch into a two here. So, here I am writing. So, let us make bigger God cells here. You know, structure of stomata we have discussed for the last class. I will draw somewhat a bigger one. So, these are nothing but God cells. So, this is a God cells. Now, this is totally a stomatal structure. And the center what you find is nothing but stomatal pore. In the diagram you can see very clearly this stomatal pore. Now, what happens here? Starch is the one with the addition of the water. It undergoes hydrolysis. As a result, it is broken down to form. Initially, it forms only one compound. That compound is called as malic acid. What it produces? A malic acid. Malic acid further gets broken down, dissociated and forms malate ions along with the H plus ions. So, what you can see now, here malate ions are there, H plus ions are also there. So, what is the first step here? Hydrolysis of starch. Starch is get converted into, with the hydrolysis, starch is converted into malic acid. Malic acid further dissociates into, two ions. What are they? Malate ions as well as H plus ions. Guys, make sure that one side you draw the diagram. One side you draw the diagram, show what's happening in the God cells. Same thing you write just beside the diagram, write down the step. Right? Now, what is the first step? Hydrolysis of starch. Let us go to the next step. In the next step here, very, very important. In the next step, there is efflux of H plus ions. There is efflux of H plus ions. So, guys, you just continue writing down and down. So, I will just write here, I will just continue up. So, here, what is the second step? Efflux of H plus ions. I will just write it up so that you can see very clearly. So here I write malate and here I write H plus. Okay. So what is the second step we have to? We have to remember second step as efflux of H plus ions. Efflux of H plus ions. Meaning what here? Efflux means going out. Who is going out? H plus ions. Going out H plus ions. How this will happen? Now I'll draw the diagram here. Look at here. Malate is as it is here, but H plus ions will come out. How H plus ions will come out here? This is called H plus transport, or you can write better, H plus ions are moving out with the help of active transport. Very, very, very important. How H plus ions are coming out? With the help of active transport. Very, very important. Why? Because H plus ions going out, if you look at, this is by active transport. Only this is active transport. Rest all processes will come under passive transport. Only this is active transport. Rest all will come under passive transport. So what happens in this active transport here? H plus is going out. Efflux of H plus ions. Now, when H plus goes out here, how H plus is going? Active transport. That is with the help of an enzyme called ATPase. Whenever you write ase means that's an enzyme that works with the help of energy. Energy is nothing but what? ATP. Now in this, pumps are involved. What are these pumps here? Pumps are nothing but carrier proteins. These carrier proteins which function, which work with the help of ATP. So pumps are nothing but carrier proteins which work with the help of ATP, and this active transport occurs against concentration gradient. It occurs against concentration gradient. Against concentration gradient means from where to where? Low concentration to high concentration. That's why they take the help of energy, and this is called active transport. Very, very, very important. Only H plus ions is nothing but active transport. Rest of all are nothing but passive transport. Okay, so again I repeat, malate ions are here, H plus ions are here. Malate ion as it is here in the God cells, but H plus ions are going out. H plus ions, how they go out? Efflux means going out. H plus is going from where to where? From inside the God cell to outside the God cell. How H plus ion is going? By the active transport. So it occurs with the help of enzyme ATPase, with the help of ATP, with the help of pumps. What are pumps? Carrier proteins which works with the help of ATP, and this happens against concentration gradient that occurs from low concentration to high concentration. Okay, so this is the second step. Let's go down with the third step. Let us go down with the third step. So I'm writing third step here. You people go down third step and fourth step, fifth step like that. So what is the third step? I'll just write down here. So we need little more space. So here the third step is now, so influx of H plus, influx of K plus. What's happening here? H plus has already gone out. Sorry, here H plus has already went out. Now to balance that, who is coming here? To balance that, who is coming here? K plus is coming. See, if you make the difference, we have made a dotted a thick line here. The thick line indicates here, the thick line what we have drawn, that is for active transport. And dotted line what we are, inflex. Inflex means coming inside. Coming inside from where to where? From outside the cell into inside the cell. It's coming from outside the cell into inside the cell. It's coming inside. Inflex of K-plex. How it is happening? By passive transport. It happens with the help of what? A passive transport. Okay, so what is passive transport? You know it very well. It is without ATP or without energy. No energy is needed, but here it happens with the help of carrier proteins. It happens with the help of carrier proteins, but these are not called pumps. In active transport only they are called pumps. Why? Because they work with the help of ATP. But here they simply call carrier proteins. Okay, but this still it is called passive transport, and this occurs along with the concentration gradient. Along with the concentration gradient means where to where it happens? From high concentration to low concentration. It happens from high concentration to low concentration. Along with the concentration gradient, high concentration to low concentration. So this is third step. Inflex means K-plex is coming inside by passive transport. By what process? By passive transport. Now go with the next step then. The next step is fourth one, that is again inflex of Cl minus. Inflex by Cl minus. Why? The K plus what's coming here, it is combining with, here already who is there? Mallet is there. Mallet combines with potassium and forms potassium malate. It forms the compound called as what? Potassium malate. Potassium is coming inside. Potassium combines with the malate and forms what is called potassium malate. So then to compensate, but still some more K plus are there here, because K plus is continuously coming from outside to inside. After the formation of potassium malate, some more K plus ions are still are there in excess quantity to balance that influx of Cl minus. Who is coming? Cl minus. Again same, Cl minus also comes by passive transport. Also comes by passive transport. Same here, without ATP, without ATP. And with the carrier protein, same points. Why? Because here it is passive transport only, and along with the concentration gradient. It happens along with the concentration gradient. Obviously from where to where? High concentration to low concentration. Where to where it's happening? High concentration to low concentration. So look at here. Now already who is there here? Already who is there here? So here potassium malate is there. Potassium malate is there. Now who is coming here? Already H plus went off. H plus went off. Who has come there? Influx of K plus. Then who is coming now? Cl minus. Now excess amount of the potassium combined with KCl lead to formation, Cl minus lead to formation of KCl, potassium chloride, right? But influx of chlorine is also occurs by passive transport. K plus also occurs by passive transport. Only efflux of H plus ions occurs by active transport, right? Now because of KCl here, now because of KCl here, what happens here? pH of the cell, pH of God cell increases. OP means osmotic potential or osmotic pressure increases, right? What is pH? pH increases. Why? Because KCl, osmotic pressure also increases, but water potential decreases. Water potential decreases. When water potential decreases here, it causes endosmosis. It causes what? Endosmosis. Now here, because of endosmosis, water enters inside, right? That causes turgidity of God cells. That causes what? Turgidity of God cells. It causes turgidity of God cells, and that causes opening of stomata. That causes what? Opening of stomata. Leads to causes. So this all parameters important. When KCl is produced here, automatically pH increases, osmotic pressure also increases. When pH and osmotic pressure increases here, what happens here? Now here, what do we say? pH has increased, osmotic pressure also increases, but you find lower water potential. As you find lower water potential here, let us take this as LS, take it as a smaller ones. Take it as a smaller ones here. Now here water enters into cell in all directions. That is what happens is called endosmosis. Why? Water always move from outside the God cells, you find higher water potential. So water moves from outside the God cell to inside the God cell. It's called endosmosis. It's called as endosmosis. As because of endosmosis, now it becomes turgid, increases in shape, that causes turgidity of the God cells, and centermost pore will get open. So it leads to what is called opening of stomata. So there is a opening of stomata. So the centermost pore will get open. So here I write stomatal pore opens. Stomatal pore opens. And this phenomena is called opening of stomata. Now let us discuss very clearly here. What are we discussing? Opening and closing of stomata. Now if you look at in the first case, as in the daytime, carbon dioxide, water, sunlight are available. First step what occurs is called hydrolysis of starch. Starch converts into malic acid. Malic acid is broken down into malate ions and H+ ions. So here starch into malic acid, malate ions and H+ ions. Then what goes out is called efflux of H+ ions. Efflux means H+ ions are started going out. They started going out, right? So here remember the process. Why? Because exactly reverse we have to write for closing of stomata. So followed by efflux of H+ ions. H+ ions are going out from inside the God cell to outside the God cell, and by the mechanism called active transport. Very, very, very important. Remember all of you, efflux of H+ ions is by active transport. Now with the help of an enzyme called ATPase that works with the help of ATP, and here carrier proteins, they need energy, they are called pumps. It happens against concentration gradient from low concentration to high concentration. So here low levels of H+. Now then followed by efflux of H+ ions, followed by influx of K+ ions. It happens by passive transport. That means when H+ goes out here, to balance that, K+ is coming inside, but we represent dotted line. That is by passive transport. We all know about passive transport. It happens without ATP, and carrier proteins are involved. They are not called pumps as like active, and it occurs along with the concentration gradient, that is from high concentration to low concentration. When potassium comes inside, potassium combines with malate, lead to formation of potassium malate. But still some more potassium ions are coming inside, these potassium ions to balance that, next there is an entry of Cl minus. So we call influx of Cl minus. That also happens by passive transport without ATP carrier proteins along with the concentration gradient, that is high to low. So both K plus and Cl minus by passive transport, only H plus efflux is active transport. Now when Cl minus enters here, it joins with potassium chloride. Now what are there? Potassium malate is there, potassium chloride is there. So pH increases. pH of the, what happens within the God cell? Within the God cells, the pH increases, osmotic pressure increases, but water potential decreases, lower water potential. These two increases. As lower water potential you find inside the God cells, outside you find higher water potential. Movement happens from higher to lower. So what occurs here, it's called endosmosis. Water comes inside, that causes turgidity of the God cells and that causes opening of stomata. This process will come for what? Opening of stomata. All of you guys followed? Now let us make it reverse for closing of stomata. Right? Now the same thing you are just going to study. Now you just taken two vertical pages, right? On one side of the vertical page you write down opening of the stomata, go down. This all part you have to write vertically down only. Now what is the second category we have? Closing of stomata. Let us discuss that. Now what we have to discuss, continuation of that, closing of stomata. Same process as we discussed the opening of stomata. Now let us make it reverse of that. What we have discussed for opening of stomata, let us make reverse of that, then we get what is called closing of stomata. So what type of stomata here we are discussing? We are discussing photoactive stomata. That means opens during daytime but closing occurs in the night time. The closing of stomata takes place at the, in the night time. Let us see what happens now. Now in the first step here there is a influx of H plus. There is an influx of H plus. How influx of H plus ions occurs? This occurs by, this is the first step, this occurs by again passive transport. This occurs by passive transport. Same thing we are writing, ma. No ATP, carrier proteins are involved. Same points will come. No ATP, carrier proteins are involved along with the concentration gradient. Along with the concentration gradient means from where to where? So we say high concentration to low concentration. Okay, so when you look at this phenomena here, what's happening here? So this is like this. So here there is a influx of H plus. So influx also we are drawing with the dotted line. Why? Because this is passive transport. This happens by passive transport. When H plus ions comes here, then what happens to malate ion? Potassium malate. What you find here already? Potassium malate. It dissociates and forms potassium and malate. Now, this malate combines with H plus ions and lead to formation of malic acid. Then potassium will be separated. So, when potassium is separated like this, so what you find here? Malate combines with H plus and need to form malic acid. Now, who is left here? This malic acid enters into TCA cycle, or we say citric acid cycle, Krebs cycle. Enters into what? Whatever the malic acid produced in the god cells, that enters into TCA cycle, Krebs cycle, citric acid cycle. Okay, we are going to discuss the TCA cycle, Krebs cycle, at the time of respiration, the next coming chapter. But try to remember, during night time, H plus again comes back. Inside, potassium malate breaks down and form potassium and malate. Now, malate combines with incoming H plus, lead to again formation of back of malic acid. Malic acid, what is formed? That enters into what is called TCA cycle. Now, then followed by the next step. What is the next step? Now, who is empty here? K plus. So, there is effects of K plus ions, and that occurs by again same passive transport means same, no ATP, carrier proteins are involved, and along with concentration gradient. So here, as this is going out, what's happening now here? So this is already here. Who is there? Malic acid is there. Now who is coming out here now? K plus is coming out. Who is coming out? K plus. How it's coming out? By the process called as passive transport. Why? Because already H plus entered. H plus entry also we write with dark line only. I mean spotted line only. Okay. So who is coming out now? K plus is coming. And K plus comes out by the process called passive transport. Then this is followed by a third step called as efflux of Cl minus ion. Efflux of Cl minus ion. So potassium chloride get dissociated, forms potassium plus and Cl minus. As this is going out here, who is left now? Cl minus. Even Cl minus also starts coming out. So what you find here in this case? Let us look at here. Who has entered here? H plus has entered. Who is leaving now? Already K plus is left. Now who is leaving now? Cl minus. Now even efflux of Cl minus is also by passive transport. Same, also by passive transport. No ATP, carrier proteins, and along with the concentration, from high concentration to low concentration. See here, who is entered? There is an influx of KH plus and there is an efflux of K plus and Cl minus. Then what happens here? Now because of this, I'm writing the next step down. The fourth step I'm just continuing here. So because of all these things, pH of the cell increases, osmotic pressure also increases. What happens to water potential? Water potential here, both of them decreases. pH decreases, osmotic pressure also decreases, water potential increases. So when there is an increase in water potential, now that results in exosmosis. And exosmosis, there is a loss of water that causes flaccidity of God cells, that causes flaccidity of the God cells, and that causes closing of stomata. That causes closing of stomata. So here you can see. Okay, now let us see what happens here. Now because of this, here already detergent, no? Right. Now pH here in this case, pH will come down and osmotic pressure also will come down, but water potential increases. That means you find higher water potential. Outside you find lower water potential. Movement occurs from higher water potential to lower water potential. Water goes out here as a result, and this leads to exosmosis, and that causes flaccidity of the cell. And this leads to flaccidity of the cell. So here you can see flaccid here. Now as a result, stomatal pore closes. Stomatal pore closes. That results in closing of stomata. Why this becomes flaccid? Because loss of water. There is a loss of water. Right? Now everything, I think, I hope you have understood very clearly. Let us make quick revision. Closing of stomata occurs in the night time. First step is influx of H plus, that occurs by passive transport. Passive transport means all of you know, no ATP, carrier proteins. It happens along with the concentration gradient, that's from high to low. So when there is an influx here, K plus is coming inside, then potassium malate breaks down, potassium forms, malate forms. Then malate combines with the H plus and forms malic acid. Malic acid enters into TCA cycle. Then followed by efflux of K plus slowly going out, again by passive transport with all parameters. When K plus goes out here, KCl breaks K plus and Cl minus, even the Cl minus starts coming out of the cell, and these three occurs: influx of H plus, efflux of K plus, efflux of Cl minus. All these three occurs by passive transport. No ATP, carrier proteins, high concentration to low concentration. Then pH decreases, osmotic pressure of the God cell also, both of them decreases, but water potential increases. See, even opening and closing of the stomata is also related to what? Water potential. It's related to water potential. Water potential increases, that causes exosmosis. So water is going out because water movement happening from higher water potential of the God cell to lower water potential. Water is moving from inside the God cell to outside the God cell, that is called exosmosis. There is a loss of water that results in flaccidity of the God cell. Cell here, all both God cells will come closure, it becomes flaccid, they come closure, and that causes what is called closing of stomata, means stomatal pore will get closed. So this is happens in the night time, that is called photoactive stomata, and this is a mechanism for closing of stomata. So here the opening and closing of stomata is a very very important mechanism. That's a very important mechanism. What you have to do is write opening of the stomata in the vertical page in one side of the paper, and write closing of stomata in another side of the paper, and go have the comparison. What is the comparison? For example, here we are writing. Sir, konjam just slightly dippan sir. Cam. Excuse me, sir. 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 కొంచెం ఇది తిప్పండి సార్. సో హియర్ ఓపెనింగ్ ఆఫ్ స్టొమాటా, లెట్ అస్ కంపేర్. వై? బికాస్ వీఆర్ రైటింగ్ వన్ సైడ్ ఓపెనింగ్ ఆఫ్ స్టొమాటా, అదర్ సైడ్ వీఆర్ రైటింగ్ క్లోజింగ్ ఆఫ్ స్టొమాటా. ఓపెనింగ్ ఆఫ్ స్టొమాటా, వాట్ ఈస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ హియర్? దేర్ ఈస్ ఎ ఎఫ్లెక్స్ ఆఫ్ హెచ్ ప్లస్. So we write exactly opposite to the closing of stomata. In closing of stomata, what happens? There is a influx of H plus. In opening, who is going out? H plus. In closing, who is coming in? H plus. Just make the differences, right? If you know opening, you can automatically write the closing, right? What is the second step here? There is a influx of K plus. So here, what is the second step here? There is an efflux of K plus. And here in opening, what is happens after K plus is coming? Accompanied by Cl minus. So Cl minus is coming inside, influx of Cl minus. What is happening here? Cl minus is going out, efflux of Cl minus. So if you compare opening and closing here with the parameters like pH and osmotic pressure and water potential. So with these parameters we are comparing both for opening of the stomata and closing of the stomata. We are taking three parameters: pH, OP means don't get confused, osmotic pressure, and then water potential. Then we are trying to differentiate. In opening, what happens? In opening, what happens? Endosmosis. So in closing, what happens? Exosmosis. In opening, endosmosis. In closing, exosmosis. Here, what happens here? It becomes turgid cell. It becomes turgid cell. Here it becomes placid cell, and this causes opening, that causes what? Closing of stomata. Just in your notebook, write side by side. Opening of the stomata in one vertical page, closing of stomata another vertical page. Compare at every step. What is coming, going out, what is coming in, who is coming inside, who is going out, and what are the parameters, and finally what happens. Let us have a comparison between opening of stomata and closing of stomata.